If you are like me, then you will avoid using nullable reference types in the domain model definition, like this reference here, and use an option of T instead. And if, by any chance, your project is using Entity Framework Core, then the inevitable question comes. How do you persist a model that contains optional objects using EF Core? There are links in the description to my other videos that explain why you will want to use optional objects instead of nullable references. In this video, I will only answer the question about persisting optional objects using EF Core. This ISBN type is just a class. It wraps a plain string, giving it the meaning of an ISBN assigned to the book. The class contains validation and nothing more. However, some books do not have an ISBN. This model of the book has solved that issue by turning the ISBN property nullable. Things become even worse when the property is a value type. This is an optional book rating. The rating is a nullable float because a book might not have it. Alright, enough of nullable types. I am about to turn both properties into options from the language ext library. That is probably the most popular functional library for C#. I have added the language ext package. Augmenting this float will help show the ideas. The property will become an option of float rather than a nullable float. A book that has no rating assigned will have none. Once the rating is assigned, it will be some. So the question in this video is, how do we persist this property using EF Core? I will first show you an attempt to apply a common mapping of an object into a database type. But that attempt will fail. I will explain why an obvious approach does not work in the case of optional objects. Let's see. We want to map the property rating, which is an option of float. Relational databases use null to specify a missing value. While we might want to avoid using null in the domain model, there is nothing more natural than using null in a relational database. Therefore, one idea could be to define a conversion from an option of float into a nullable float in the database. So let's try to define this mapping. We would convert some into the contained float and none into a null. This wouldn't work in language ext. The match method does not allow null returns. Since float is a value type, I would need to use the toNullable method instead. The reverse mapping would be more explicit. If the nullable float has a value, then we put that value into the sum option. Otherwise, the result is a none option. That is what toOption method from the prelude class does. This looks straightforward. I would bet my money that it would work. But it will not. There is a strange warning when adding a migration. It says that the rating is a collection or enumeration type. The option of T is implementing the IEnumerable of T as a matter of convenience. You can apply a link to optional objects. EF Core has misinterpreted that and now it requires a comparer. That's just not what I need. However, the greater problem is on the horizon. Look at the migration. It says that the underlying database type is not nullable. Well, that is an issue. It also says that the default value is zero. That is precisely what I didn't want to have. I wanted a nullable real value in the database. What is the issue? I am removing the migration. This attempt has failed. So what is the issue? It is that EF Core does not allow the conversion of a non-nullable type in the model into a nullable database column. It would translate a database null into a null reference in memory and vice versa. I could make a desperate attempt by insisting that this property is not required, but that would result in the same looking migration. So this attempt didn't work either. I will repeat that the reason is in the fundamental proposition of Entity Framework Core. It refuses to translate a non-nullable type into a nullable database column. You may try to solve the problem using shadow properties, for example. That would look like fighting against EF Core, in my opinion. I want a solution that is aligned with the spirit of EF Core. It must also be aligned with the spirit of language ext. So essentially, the situation is that I am standing between two libraries where neither one acknowledges the existence of the other. From this point on, I will actively solve the problem. My goal is to align with the principles of EF Core while using the language text option the way it was designed. Let me remind you that you can download the entire source code before and after the change from my Patreon page. Patrons are the reason why this channel is free. If you become a patron, you will help hundreds of other fellow programmers watch more than 100 videos on my channel for free. There are other things in this project that were not in the spirit of EF Core, and yet they worked pretty well. The release class is modeling a release of a book, including the publisher, the edition, and notably the publication information. This is the publication info. It is a discriminated union. You can watch my other videos about discriminated unions. The links are in the description. C# does not support discriminated unions yet, but when they come into the language, they will look similar to this. And they are a problem for EF Core as well. Still, I did persist this discriminated union. It was easy in the end. The problem was that EF Core cannot map a single object into multiple database columns. It cannot map a hierarchy of types into a complex property either. So I chose to flatten out the entire discriminated union into a flat structure with only two properties supported by EF Core. Then I'm persisting that object instead. The type object will be saved in a varchar column containing the name of the type. The publication date, which is another discriminated union, will be encoded in a numeric column in the database. It all works just fine, saving two properties into two database columns. But how did I accomplish that in the domain model? The trick was to accompany that property with a private one. EF Core will use the property getter when saving the data. You can see that I'm converting a full publication object into that persistable version. The setter is doing the opposite. It transforms the database object into the full publication info object and sets the main property. Can we do the same with the book's optional objects? Let's try with the same idea regarding the public option of float, which I only use in the object-oriented part of the application. The relational part will use a private nullable float property that is easy to map with EF Core. I will need both the getter and the setter. The getter will just convert the rating to a nullable float. The setter will do the opposite. It will accept a nullable float and convert it to an option using the language ext prelude class. EF Core will operate on this private property. Everybody else in the application will only see the public option of float property. That is ideal. Configuring the mapping will be straightforward. We tell EF Core to ignore the public property. Then configure the private nullable float rating representation property. Persist it in the column name rating. Effectively, this private property is taking over the mapping of the public property, which is now ignored. When I create the migration, everything will go smooth. This is the migration. You will see that the column is nullable this time, precisely as we needed it to be. This is how I persist optional value types in my designs. Then how do we approach the reference type? The protocol is the same. The nullable property will be private again, used only by the persistence layer. The public property would be an option of ISBN. Then we prepare the getter and the setter. To get the nullable ISBN, start with an option. We must use the matchUnsafe method for this because the match method throws if we attempt to return null from it. That is how LanguageText works. Setting the nullable reference from the database requires some analysis. Null becomes none and a proper object constructed from the database row would become a sum. We can now safely work with the option public property. Configuring the database will be easy again. We are actually persisting the representation property, which is private. It will take over the column name ISBN. I must instruct EF Core to ignore the public property. The nullable ISBN column already existed in the database before this demo. Therefore, the new migration will be empty. I have augmented the domain model to use an optional ISBN instead of the nullable one. Yet, I have configured persistence to save it in the column that existed in the database long ago. I will remove this needless migration, and with that we are done. This is the domain model that supports both worlds. Null references will exist on the edges of the system, such as JSON serialization or database persistence. Inside the application, all references will be non-null and all types will be non-nullable.